So now let's move to the step method number 3, which is step deviation method, right? Now suppose that what if the values of fi's and di's are also very large? That means again the method 2 will become slightly difficult. So to make that particular method easier, we have the method 3, which is step deviation method. And remember that very important thing to use this method is that this method can only be used when the values of xi's are equally spaced. Now see, in the previous, in this question number 5, we can't use this particular method because the values of xi's are not equally spaced. The difference between first and second value is 3, which is 63 and 60, and the difference between third and fourth value is 6, right? So we cannot use that this method, right? So what are the steps to use this step deviation method? So the first step is very same, which is first we'll have to select the middlemost value of the variate or the xi's, which is called as assumed mean, right? Now in second step, we have to calculate the constant difference between the values of xi's, which is denoted by h. Now it is equal to x2 minus 1. It is also equal to x3 minus 2. That means the value of h is equal to the difference between the two consecutive values of the x. So after we have calculated the value of a, which is assumed mean, and after we have calculated the value of h, then we move on to step number 3. We have to calculate the value of ui. Now what is ui? Ui is equal to xi minus a divided by h. If you remember, what was xi minus a? The xi minus a is actually di. That means we have to calculate the value of di divided by h, and then we have to use the given below formula to find out the mean. Now I know that it is difficult in the first go to remember all these steps, but we'll do it do the next question step by step using the step deviation method. Now this is question number 6, and we have to use the step deviation method to find out the mean of this given data. Now why can we use the step deviation method? We can use the step deviation method because the values of xi's are equally spaced, and if you can see what is the difference between the values of the two consecutive values, it is 2. 20 minus 18 is 2, 22 minus 20 is 2, and 26 minus 24 and 24 minus 22 is 2. That means the value of h is constant, and therefore we can use the value of step this method, step deviation method. Now the first step was we have to choose the value of assumed mean. Before that, let us write the values of xi, which is 18, 20, 22, 24 and 25. These are the values of xi's. Now we have to write out the values of fi. What is fi? It is 170, then 530, then 230, then 110, and we have 50. Now what was the step that we have to follow? Sorry, the step was we have to calculate, we have to choose a suitable value, which is assumed mean. Now what is assumed mean? Assumed mean will lie in the middle of all the values of xi. That means the middle is 22. That means 22 is our assumed mean for this particular, for this ungrouped frequency distribution. Now step 2, we have to calculate the value of h, which is the difference between two consecutive value, and we know the, sorry, this is 26. The difference between any two consecutive value in this is 2. So this is the value of h, which is equal to 2. Now calculate ui equals to xi minus a divided by h. But before that, we have to calculate the value of xi minus a. That means we have to calculate the value of di, which is xi minus a. What is di? Di is equal to xi minus this assumed mean, which is 22. So 18 minus 22 is minus 4. 20 minus 22 is minus 2. 22 minus 22 is 0. 24 minus 22 is 2, and 26 minus 22 is 4. These are the values of di. Now the step 3 we have to calculate ui. Ui is equal to di divided by h. What is h? D, and these are the values of di. So minus 4 divided by h, which is 2, is minus 2. Minus 2 divided by 2 is minus 1. 0 divided by 2 is 0. 2 by 2 is 1 and 4 by 2 is 2. That means we have further brought these values of di to a lower value. Now it is difficult to find out the product of 170 and minus 4, but it is easier to find out the sum of 170 and minus 2. So here is the benefit of using the step deviation method over assumed method. Now we have to calculate the values of F1 U1 F2 U2 and F3 U3 and so on, so that we can find out the sum and thereby finding out the numerator in this formula. So what are the values of FIs and UIs? That means we have to multiply this column of FI and UI. 170 into minus 2 is minus 340. 530 into minus 1 is minus 530. 230 into 0 is 0. 110 into 1 is 110, and 50 into 2 is 100. Right? Now we have completed all the steps, and the last step we have to use this formula, which is a plus h into, this is the sign of multiplication, h into the sum of f1 u1 plus f2 u2 and so on. That means we have to find out the value of the sum of this last column, so that we can find out the value of this numerator. Now when you add up all of these, you will see the sum will come out to be minus 660. So this is what? This is equal to the numerator. Now also we have to calculate the values of sum of all the frequencies, which is f1 plus f2 plus f3 and so on. That means we have to calculate the sum of this particular column of fi. Now if you add them, 170, 530, 230, 110 and 50, you will see the value will come out to be 1090. Right? Now this is my denominator, which is sum of all the frequencies. This is my numerator, which is sum of all the FIs and UIs. Now I just have to implement the formula. So mean is equal to A, which is 22, plus H. What was my H? H was 2. So 22 plus 2 into numerator divided by denominator. What is my numerator? This column, which is minus 660 divided by, sorry, it is minus 660 divided by denominator. What is denominator? 1090. Now the value of this particular numerator and denominator, when you solve this particular fraction, which is minus 660 divided by 1090, the value of this comes out to be approximately equal to minus 0.6. So this means this becomes equal to 22 plus 2 into minus 0.6, right? This is the value, which is 22 plus 2 into minus 0.6. Now what is 2 into 0.6? The value of 2 into 0.6 is 1.2, and we have a negative sign. So the answer is 22 minus 2 into minus 0.6, which is 1.2. Now when you calculate this value, which is 22 minus 1.2, the answer will come out to be, sorry, the answer comes out to be, this is 22, this, why I have written this 22, this is my assumed mean, right? So 22 minus 1.2 is 20.8. So what is 20.8? 20.8 is my mean of this frequency distribution. Let me again take you to the question. This is my frequency distribution. This is question number 6. And 20.8 is the value of the mean of this frequency distribution. Now, if you want to do it with the direct method, you will take a longer time, right? And if you want to do it with the assumed mean method, you will take a lesser time than the direct method, but again you will take a longer time when compared to this step deviation method. That means step deviation method is the method in which you take the least time to find out the value of the mean of the ungrouped frequency distribution.